Guru Mani. Hare Krishna. Om Jnanatam Arandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chaksur Militanyena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Srimati Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namane. Namaste Saraswati Devi Kauravani Pracharine. Nirvisesha Shunyavadi Paschacha Desha Tarine Vanchakalpatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasade Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're beginning chapter 54. It's entitled Krishna Defeats All the Princes from the Krishna book. So in the previous chapter, we heard how Lord Krishna had come to the home of Rukmini, where her father and her brothers were preparing for her marriage. But Rukmini was supposed to be married to Sishupal. The brother of Rukmini, his name was Rukmi, he was a friend of Sishupal and he did not like Lord Krishna. So he arranged that his sister would marry Sishupal. And they invited all of the friends, all of the other demon kings to come. So kings like Jarasandha and other different, Salva and Pundraka, they all came to attend the marriage of Rukmini. And they were thinking she was going to marry Sishupal, who was their friend. But Lord Krishna got the message from the Brahmana. Rukmini had sent the Brahmana, remember, with a message. And the Brahmana had gone to Dwarka. And Lord Krishna had came immediately on his chariot. And he came alone with the Brahmana. And he just came into the assembly. And when Rukmini came, Rukmini had gone to worship Ambika in the temple. And she was coming from the temple. And at that point, Krishna just came and picked her up and put her on his chariot and drove off with her. So all of the kings were very angry, and we're going to hear now how they try to win back, they try to defeat Krishna, they try to get revenge on Krishna for taking Rukmini. That type of marriage is called a Rakshasa marriage. It's not uncommon in those days. The different kings, they wanted to marry a young woman. They would just steal her and kidnap her and they'd go off with her. And once the woman has been touched by another man, then no one will claim her because she's already been touched by someone else. So no other man will ever consider to accept her as a wife. So because Lord Krishna had already touched Rukmini by picking her up and putting her on his chariot, so she was already accepted by Lord Krishna. And you know, and she cannot get married to anybody else. But all of these other kings, they want to get revenge. So the chapter begins that Jarasandha and all the other princes were very angry at Krishna because they know Krishna had kidnapped Rukmini. So they were so attracted by the beauty of Rukmini that when they saw Rukmini, because Rukmini, you have to understand, Rukmini is not an ordinary girl. She was a young girl at this time, actually. She wasn't very old. She was just a young girl. But she was very, very beautiful. And it said that these kings, when they saw her, they were so overwhelmed by her beauty that they would fall from the, they'd fall off their horses. Oh, Hare Krishna, you're back.
Yeah, I'm back. Sorry. I don't know what happened.
Okay, yeah. So now you translate. Yeah. All right.
Can I translate what you have said just now?
Okay.
刚才就说到了那个是Krishna 他就来把 Rukmini 给绑架走，那这种婚姻方式 Rakshasa 婚姻方式，就是在那个时代也并不是罕见的，也是一种结婚的方式，就是一个男子过来把一个女子给抢走，然后因为他已经触碰过这个女子，所以没有任别的男子就不能再。 不会再要他，不会再娶她为妻子，所以这也是一种方式。OK.
So Jarasandha and the other kings were very angry at Krishna, and they came to chase him.
然后如果Rukmini她的美貌就令那个就是王子都从马上跌了下来，然后等他们又重新回过神来以后，他们就开始追赶 Krishna.
They got first of all they picked up all their weapons and they got themselves ready to go and fight him. And they got their bows and their arrows and they got on their elephants and on their horses and they went chasing after Krishna. But Lord Krishna's brother Balaram heard that Krishna had gone there alone. So when Balaram heard that Krishna had gone there alone, he came there with an army. So Balaram came with the Yadu dynasty, the army of the Yadu dynasty. And they came, when all these kings were chasing Krishna, Balaram came with his army of the Yadu dynasty and they blocked their path. So there was a huge, big battle between the Yadu dynasty and all of these kings who were the friends of Sishupal. There were kings like Jarasandha and other kings, and they all had their armies with them. So they were all there fighting against Balaram and the Yadu dynasty.
在一方有巴拉萨姆达以及他的军队，在另外一方有巴拉拉玛以及亚杜王朝的军队。And
they were all expert in fighting, and they fired so many arrows that it was like a cloud pouring rain on a mountain.
因为他们都骁勇善战，他们拼命地朝亚杜王朝士兵射箭，那架势仿佛是乌云对着山坡泼下磅礴大雨。
Just like when a cloud comes on the mountain, the cloud will not move much. It will just pour the water onto the mountain. So that when it rains on the mountain, the rain will be very heavy. You get heavier rain on the mountain than any other place.
这个下雨的力量要比在其他地方的力量要更猛烈。
So all of these kings like Jarasandha, they were very determined to defeat Krishna and bring back Rukmini.
所有这些国王包括Jarasandha,他们都下定决心要把 Rukmini从Krishna手中夺回来。
And at this time Rukmini was just sit on the side of Krishna's chariot, and when she saw all the arrows falling on them, she became very afraid.
Rukmini就坐在Krishna身边，看到王子们把箭雨劈头盖脸的射向亚杜王朝的士兵，就惊慌地看着Krishna的脸。
She was worried about all the Yadu army because they were firing so many arrows onto the Yadu army. She thought they'll all be killed. At the same time, she was with Krishna, so she wanted to show Krishna that she was grateful that Lord Krishna had come and saved her from getting married to Shishupal. And she could also understand that Krishna was taking a big risk, that he was risking his own life to come and take her and kidnap her in front of all of these kings. And at the same time, she felt sorry. She felt sorry, and Krishna could see from her face that she was worried about the whole situation. Hari Bol? Hari Bol? Okay, so we'll just continue until she comes back. So Lord Krishna could see the worry which was on Rukmini's face. She was worried about the danger which had been caused simply because of her. Simply for the sake of Rukmini, this whole battle was taking place. And Lord Krishna could see her worried look on her face. So Lord Krishna said to her, Rukmini, don't worry. My dear Rukmini, don't worry. Everything will be all right. The soldiers of the Yadu dynasty will defeat all of these opposing soldiers very quickly. You don't have to worry. Hari Bol? Hari Bol, Gurumani? So, as... Hare Krishna? So Krishna was speaking with Rukmini. At that time, the commanders, the people who were in charge of Lord Balaram's army, the Yadu dynasty, they had wonderful soldiers in their army, right? There was people, Lord Balaram, he's also known as Sankarshan. And then there's also Gada there. Gada is one of the brothers of Lord Krishna and Balaram. And he's also a great fighter. And they didn't tolerate any of the defiant attitude. Hare Krishna. Hari Bol.
Hare Krishna. Yeah, good day. Sati called me there to continue.
Okay. You're going to translate? Tulsi Gopinath,
yeah? Yeah, yeah.
Okay, we'll try. I think the internet's very unstable for some reason, but we'll try.
Yeah, the internet.
Yeah.
Where are you talking about the chapter?
Chapter number 54, yeah? Krishna.
Yeah, okay.
And I'm talking, you know, I'm giving a summary of what's told here. You just translate what I say.
Yeah, okay.
So, Lord Krishna was speaking to Rukmini, and because he'd kidnapped Rukmini from the marriage, so she was on his chariot. So Krishna told Rukmini, don't worry, everything will be all right. The Yadu dynasty had wonderful fighters in their army. Along with Lord Balaram, there was also people like Gadha, who is one of the brothers of Krishna.
在亚度王朝当中有很多骁勇善战的战士，有 Balarama 在那里，还有 Ganda。这个 Ganda 呢是 Krishna 的一个兄弟。
So they began to fight. The Yadu dynasty were fighting these kings headed by Jarasandha who were attacking them.
所以呢，这个亚度王朝的这些战士们呢，就开始与这个对方作战，这个与Jarasandha为首的这个。
And within a very short time, many of the army who were attacking them, they'd all been killed and they were all cut to pieces.
在很短的时间之内呢，这些攻击他们的这些人呢，都被杀死了，都被撕成了碎片。
They'd all fallen on the battlefield.
他们都倒在了战场上面。
Their hands were cut off, and their head. Their heads were cut off.
他们的头都被割了下来。
And their different weapons were all laying on the ground.
所有的这些武器都散落在地面上。
And the animals which they were on, like the horses and the elephants, they were also fallen. They'd also fallen down. They'd been killed.
还有那些。坐在那个马背大象身上面的那些士兵也都摔了下来，被杀死了。
So the enemy was head, the person in charge was a big demon king called Jarasandha.
对方的这个敌方的阵营呢，是以 Jarasandha 这个大恶魔为首领。
So when he saw how his army was being defeated by the soldiers of Balaram and Krishna, then he decided it's not a good idea to keep fighting.
So when he saw that his soldiers were being defeated by Balaram and Krishna, then he decided it's not a good idea to keep fighting. So when he saw how his army was being defeated by Balaram and Krishna, then he decided it's not a good idea to keep
He thought, why should I risk so many of my soldiers? Why should I risk the lives of so many of my soldiers just for the sake of Sishupal? Sishupal, he should have fought himself to get Rukmini back from Krishna.
Sishupal, he should have fought himself to get Rukmini back from Krishna.
But actually, they knew Sishupal wasn't equal to Krishna. He wouldn't be competent to fight with Krishna.
但是西树帕他的力量远远不足够打败 Krishna.
So they thought, why should we risk our own army just for his sake?
所以这个加尔山呢，他就在想呢，我为什么要牺牲我自己的士兵？来为了西树帕尔而作战呢
？So they all stopped fighting and they went back. They went home.
所以呢，他们就都停止了作战，然后就各自回家了。
But some of the princes, just out of good manners, they came to see Sishupal.
然后，但是呢，其中有一些王子，他们有非常虔诚的行动，然后他们就来到西树帕尔面前。
And they could see Sishupal was really, really unhappy because he had lost the person who was supposed to be his wife.
他们看到了这个西树帕尔非常非常的不高兴，因为呢，他失去了原本的应该成为他妻子的那个女人。
And so his face was all dried up, and he'd lost all his no energy anymore.
所以呢，他就拉扯着。
And there was no color in his body anymore.
他的身体也黯然无光。
So the kings came to Shishupal, and they tried to comfort Shishupal. They tried to console him.
所以这些王子呢，他们就出于礼貌来到希树帕尔面前，试图安慰他。
So they said, Shishupal, don't be discouraged. Don't let this worry you.
他们对希树帕尔说道，亲爱的希树帕尔，不要这么灰心丧气的，请不要这样。
You are a Kshatriya, you're a member of the kings, you're a king, and you are the chief among all the fighters.
你是一名查崔亚，而且呢，你是皇室的成员，是武士们的首领。
So you shouldn't, don't take this bad, and don't feel distress, because just understand that this is not eternal.
因此呢，请不要感到难过，也不要觉得这是非常痛苦的。因为呢，这些都不是永恒存在的。
Don't be too disappointed, because it's just a temporary thing. It went wrong.
所以说不要感到太失望，不要觉得很悲伤。这些呢都只不过是一些短暂的事情。
You have to remember, we're not the ultimate cause of everything. We're not the final doers of everything.
你要知道呢，我们不是所有事情的原因，我们不是所有事情的作为者。
Just like a puppet dances. Who's got that thing in the background? Is that from you, Tosi Gopinath?
No. 请大家静下音。
Who's making all that noise in the background? Turn off your microphone.
Hare Krishna, 那个知行合一这位奉献者，请您静下音，您的耳麦打开了。知行合一这位奉献者。
Okay, many, a lot of people don't speak Chinese also, you know. Okay, just like a puppet is in the hands of someone, so we are also like puppets, and we are just dancing in the hands of the Supreme.
正如呢，这个木偶被人们在人们手中被操纵着，同样的，我们都在至尊意志的控制下。被操纵着，就像木偶一样。
So everything goes on under his plan, and according to his plan, sometimes we enjoy, sometimes we suffer.
所以呢，所有的事情都在根据他的至尊意愿而进行着。
We have
根据他的至尊意愿，有的时候我们受苦，有的时候我们享乐。
We have to be steady in every situation.
所以呢，在任何情况下，我们都要保持平衡，保持心理的平衡。
So in the beginning, the kings who were coming to the wedding, they were full of hope that they were going to see that Shishupal was married to Rukmini.
所以这些王子，当他们刚开始参加婚礼的时候，他们的心中都是充满希望的，他们想要看到这个 Shishupal 和 Rukmini 结婚。
But then Krishna came and defeated all their plans, and they couldn't do anything about it.
但是呢，这个 Krishna 就是破坏了他们所有的计划，而他们不知道该怎么办。
So they could only try to encourage Shishupal. They tried to flatter Shishupal.
所以他们就试图鼓励 Shishupal， 他们就尝试着安慰他。
So Shishupal, he couldn't marry Rukmini. He had to be satisfied with these words of his friends, the kind words of his friends.
这个 Shishupal 呢，他没有能够娶到 Rukmini 为妻。他听到了这些王子们对他的这些一番奉承的话之后呢，就不开心的回家了。
He went home. So Shishupal went home, but very disappointed.
所以他非常失望的回家了。
And the kings who had all come to support Shishupal, they were also disappointed that they couldn't help him, and they also went home to their kingdoms.
所以那些来参加西什泡婚礼的那些王子们呢，他们也非常的失望，因为他们觉得他们没有办法帮助到西什泡，所以那些王子们也各自回家去了。
So the it was all actually due to Rukmini's elder brother Rukmi. He was the one who had actually arranged the marriage.
所有的这一切呢，都是因为 Rukmini 的哥哥 Rukmi 是 Rukmi 安排了这一场婚礼。
So he saw his sister, he saw Rukmini taken away by Krishna. So he was really disappointed because he wanted her to marry Shishupal.
但是呢，他眼睁睁地看到他自己的妹妹被Krishna 强行带走了。这个 Rukmi 他感到非常的失望，因为他原本想要把他的妹妹嫁给 Shishupal。
But now everything is changed, and Rukmini's gone off with Krishna, and Shishupal doesn't have anybody to marry.
所以呢，现在呢，所有的事情，这一切的事情都发生了改变。Rukmini 呢，即将成为 Krishna 的妻子，与 Krishna 成婚，而 Shishupal 呢，却没有任何人与他结婚。
So Rukmini's older brother Rukmi was really agitated.So he decided he has to teach Krishna a lesson. He said he thought, I will personally go and fight him and kill him.
So, this Rukmini, Rukmi, 就是 Rukmini 的哥哥 Rukmi, 他感到非常的愤怒，所以他下定决心呢，要给 Krishna 一个教训。他就决定呢，要亲自去与 Krishna 作战，要杀死 Krishna.
And so he got his army. He had a big army, many thousands of elephants and horses and chariots.As well as soldiers, and he got them all with all their weapons, and he began to go to Krishna, to follow Krishna to Dwarka.
所以呢，这个 Rukmi 他就召集了自己的士兵，他有一组这个由成千上万的大象、步兵，还有战车等等构成的一个军队。然后呢，他就率领着这支全副武装的军队去追赶。
And he told people, he told the kings, he said, you did not help Shishupal, he was supposed to marry my sister. He said, but I'm not going to allow Krishna to take my sister.
他就对那些之前的那些王子们就说呢，你们没有帮助那个没有帮助 Shishupal, 赢回我的妹妹。但是现在呢，我不会允许这个 Krishna 把我的妹妹带走。
I'm going to teach him a lesson. I'm going to follow him, and I'm going to fight him.
现在呢，我要亲自教训他一顿。我这样呢，我就去追他。
And he vowed, until I kill Krishna, I'm in the fight and bring back my sister, I will not come back to her kingdom. I won't come back to her city.
这个 Rukmi 他就发誓说呢，除非我杀死 Krishna， 把我的妹妹从他的手中夺回来，否则呢，我就不会回到我的王国，不会回到我的首都。
And so he told everybody like that. He said, "Wait, now you see, I'll keep my vow."
所以呢，他就在所有的人面前发誓。他就说我一定会实现我的誓言。
So this was very boasting words for Rukmi to speak. He was being very foolish to speak such a big claim.
实际上那个 Rukmi 他说的这番话呢，实际上是夸下的海口，是只不过是说的大话而已，他不应该说这些话。
Anyway, he got on his chariot and he told his chariot driver to go after Krishna. I want to fight with him.
然后呢，他就坐上了战车，然后命令他的车夫驾车追赶 Krishna.
And he said, this cowherd boy has become proud of his tricks.
他说呢，这个牧牛童，以他的诡计为傲。
He said, today I will teach him a good lesson.
现在呢，我要好好教训他一番。
He's no right to kidnap my sister.
他没有权利绑架我的妹妹。
I'm going to pierce his body with my sharp arrows, and I will teach him a good lesson.
我要用我的利剑射穿他的身体，好好的教训他一番。
So Rukmi was very ignorant. He didn't know the real position of Lord Krishna.
这个 Rukmi 他实际上是一个很愚蠢的人，他不知道 Krishna 真正的地位。
And he did not understand that Krishna is actually the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
他并不知道 Krishna 实际上是至尊人格首身。
So he came in front of Krishna, and very foolishly, he told to Krishna, he said, just stop for a minute and fight with me.
所以说呢，这个 Rukmi 他就驾着这个战车追赶上了 Krishna。然后呢，这个威胁 Krishna 说：“你停下来，我要与你作战。”
And he had his bow and he shot arrows into Krishna's body. He shot three arrows into Krishna's body.
所以呢，他就拿起了这个弓箭，向 Krishna 的身体发了三箭。
And he said to Krishna, "You're the most condemned descendant of the Yadu dynasty."
他就骂 Krishna， 他说 Krishna 是亚度王朝最令人憎恶的后裔。
Said you have taken away my sister, just like a crow steals butter meant to be used in the sacrifice.
他说呢，你偷走了我的妹妹，就好比是乌鸦偷走了本来该用于祭祀的酥油。
You're proud of your strength.
你为你的力量感到骄傲。
But you cannot fight according to regulative principles.
但是呢，你却不能按照这个原则来作战。
You stole my sister.
你偷走了我的妹妹。
Now I'm going to take away your pride.
现在呢，我要去除你的虚荣。
And you can keep my sister in your possession only.If you can beat me to the ground.
他说呢，你只能在我用剑杀死你之前拥有我的妹妹。
You can keep my sister in your possession until I beat you to the ground.
他说呢，除非我把你杀死，否则你不可能拥有我的妹妹。
So Lord Krishna heard these very foolish words from Rukmi. So Lord Krishna fired an arrow.At him.
Krishna 呢，他就听到了 Rukmi 的这一番非常愚蠢的说话，然后呢，他就向 Rukmi 发了一箭。
And he fired the arrow. It cut the string on Rukmi's bow, and so he wasn't able to use that bow again.
他的这一箭呢，就把那个 Rukmi 的弓箭给射断了。这样的话呢 ，Rukmi 就不可能再向他射箭了。
So Rukmi, he got another bow, and then this time he fired five arrows at Krishna.
这个时候呢 ，Rukmi 他就拿起了另一张弓箭，向 Krishna 又射了五箭。
So again, Krishna cut the string on the bow. He fired an arrow to cut the string on Rukmi's bow.
这一次呢 ，Krishna 又把他的弓箭给射断了。
So Rukmi got a third bow, and Krishna did the same thing.
然后 Rukmi 他又拿了第三个弓箭，结果又被 Krishna 射断了。
And then Krishna fired six arrows at Rukmi.
这个时候呢 ，Krishna 就反而向 Rukmi 射了六箭。
And he fired eight arrows, killed the four horses on his pulling his chariot.
他射了，他又射了八箭，然后其中有四箭呢，杀死了这个他的四匹马。
Yeah, and the chariot driver was killed with another arrow.
然后其中有一件杀死了他的车夫。
And he cut off the different parts of Rukmi's chariot with the other arrows. Cut off the flag.
然后呢，他就用剩下的这三根剑呢，就把那个 Rukmi 的战车，给摧毁了，就是把他的那些战车上面的旗帜呀、什么的都射掉了。
So Rukmi had no more arrows, so he took other weapons. He got his sword and he got tridents and different weapons. He came to fight.
这个时候呢 ，Rukmi 他没有了弓箭，但是呢，他拿起了其他。
But whatever weapon he came with, Krishna would just cut it to pieces.
但是呢，无论他使用什么武器，结果都被 Krishna, 射成了碎片。
So Rukmi was defeated, but then Rukmi tried a last attempt. He took his sword and he came running towards Krishna.
这个时候呢 ，Rukmi 他已经恼羞成怒了，他就抓起了佩刀冲向 Krishna.
But Rukmi was just like a fly running into a fire.
Rukmi 就像这个飞蛾一样，扑向了这个火焰。
And when Rukmi reached Krishna just cut his weapon to pieces.
当 Rukmi 接近 Krishna 的时候呢 ，Krishna 就把他的武器砍成了碎片。
Then Krishna took out his sword, and with his sword he was about to kill him, but then Rukmini came there, and she pleaded to Krishna.
这个时候呢 ，Krishna 他抽出了自己的这个宝刀，准备杀死 Rukmini。但是呢，看到这一情景 ，Rukmini 上前来，劝那个 Krishna 不要杀死他哥哥。
Rukmini fell down at Krishna's feet, and she was trembling in fear, and she pleaded with Krishna not to kill her brother.
Rukmini 呢，他就拜倒在 Krishna 的莲花足下，他因为非常的恐惧而身体颤抖着，他非常悲伤的，以非常悲伤的语调恳求 Krishna.
She addressed Krishna as Yogeshwara.
他把 Krishna 称呼为 Yogeshwara.
It means one who has inconceivable opulence.
Yogeshwara 的意思是拥有不可思议的财富的人。
And also inconceivable energy.
拥有不可思议的财富和不可思议的能量。
But Rukmini's brother, he only has a little power.
但是呢，这个 Rukmini 的哥哥 Rukmi 只有一点点的力量。
So Krishna is.Unlimited, but Rukmini's brother was very limited.
Krishna 呢是无限的，而他的哥哥 Rukmi 无论在哪一个方面都是极为有限的。
So Rukmini's brother Rukmi was he couldn't compare to Krishna.
所以呢，这个 Rukmini 的哥哥 Rukmi 在任何方面都是不可能与 Krishna 匹敌的。
Rukmini knows the position of Krishna. Hare Krishna? Tosi Gopinath? Oh, yeah.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, are you there? Okay, you're back. Okay, I couldn't hear
yeah.
you.
Yeah, I'm there.
Okay, I couldn't hear you. All right, so...Rukmini addresses Krishna as the God of Gods.
Rukmini 把 Krishna 称为众神之神。
There are many powerful demigods like Brahma and Shiva.
宇宙中有很多的半神人，比如说 Brahma、Shiva。
But Krishna is the Lord of all of these gods.
但是呢 ，Krishna 是所有这些半神人的主人。
And Rukmini's brother, he was just an ordinary human being.
And Rukmini's brother, Rukmi, 只不过是一个普通的人类。
And he was actually really low because he did not understand who Krishna was.
而实际上呢，他的地位非常的低等，因为他根本不知道 Krishna 是谁。
If somebody doesn't know who is Krishna, then he's the lowest person in human society.
如果一个人不知道 Krishna 是谁的话，那他就是人类社会中最低等的人。
So then Rukmini addressed, she called Krishna Mahabhuja, meaning one who has unlimited strength.
Rukmini 把 Krishna 称呼为 Mahabhuja, 意思是拥有无限力量的人。
And she called Krishna as Jagatpati, the master of the whole cosmic manifestation.
她也把 Krishna 称呼为 Jagatpati, 意思是整个宇宙展示的主人。
So this way Rukmini compared the position of her brother with that of Krishna.
就这样呢 Rukmini 就比较了她的哥哥和 Krishna 的地位之间相差悬殊。她以这样的方式做了比较。
Rukmini's brother Rukmi, he's a very insignificant person compared to Krishna.
跟 Krishna 相比较而言 Rukmini 的哥哥 Rukmi 只不过是一个非常微不足道的普通人。
And in this way Rukmini pleaded to Krishna that he should not kill her brother.
就像这样呢 Rukmini 恳求 Krishna 不要杀死他的哥哥 Rukmi.
Especially because this is an auspicious time.Because Krishna has just kidnapped Rukmini, so she didn't want anything inauspicious to happen, like her brother being killed.
尤其是呢，那是一个非常吉祥的场合，因为 Krishna 他刚刚绑架了 Rukmini， 因此呢 ，Rukmini 他不希望在这样一个大喜的日子里有不吉祥的事情发生，比如说他的哥哥被杀死这种事。
So this way Rukmini was showing her position as a woman. As a woman, women are generally kind-hearted.
因此呢 ,Rukmini 在这里展示了她女性的一面。女性通常心地柔软。
So she was happy to get Krishna as her husband.
她非常高兴得到 Krishna 作为她的丈夫。
Especially when she didn't want to marry the man who her brother had arranged for her, she didn't want to marry Sishupal.
尤其是她不想嫁给她的哥哥 Rukmi 给她安排的那个丈夫，她并不想跟 Sishupal 结婚。
But she didn't want to have her brother killed either. She wanted to keep her brother.
但是呢，她也不希望她的哥哥被杀死。她希望她的哥哥活着。
Because she knew her brother loved her, that she's his younger sister, so the brother loved her.
因为她知道她的哥哥非常的爱她，她是她的妹妹，她知道她的哥哥爱她。
And in her brother's opinion, he thought Sishupal was a good husband for his sister.
因为她知道以她哥哥的这个。角度来说呢，他认为西苏帕尔是他妹妹的好丈夫。
So while Rukmini was praying to Krishna, her body was trembling because of the anxiety. She was so worried.
就像这样呢 ，Rukmini 一直在恳求 Krishna。他因为他内心呢非常的焦虑，使得他的身体都开始颤抖。
And her face.Began to dry up and her throat choked.
她的这个面容变得憔悴，喉咙也哽咽的说不出话来。
And the ornaments on her body, they all became loose and they fell to the ground.
她身上戴的这些首饰呢，都散落了一地，掉到了地上。
And she also fell on the ground. Rukmini also fell on the ground, and Krishna.Became compassionate on her, and he thought, I won't kill him.
这个 Rukmini 呢，他因为他强烈的这种焦虑和恐慌，也摔倒在了地上。这个时候呢 ，Krishna 看到这一情景，就对他产生了怜悯之情。
But he wanted to give Rukmi some punishment, so he began to cut off some of his hair and some of his mustache and some of his beard.
但是呢 Krishna 呢仍然想要惩罚一下 Rukmini， 所以呢他就把他的胡子和头发。
Because he's a Kshatriya, the Kshatriyas, they don't shave their face. They have big beards and they have long hair. So it was a disgrace to have his beard and his hair cut. Haribo? Tulsi Gopinath? Hare Krishna? Hare Krishna?
Can you hear me?
Now you're back. You just come back, okay?
Yeah, the internet not steady.
Yeah, very unsteady, yeah.
Rukmini 呢，他因为他是查崔亚，查崔亚呢，通常他们都不会那个修剪他们的胡须和头发，所以说呢，他们都留着长长的这个头发还有胡须。所以说他们的这个头发和胡须如果被剃掉的话，被敌人剃掉的话呢，这对他们来说是极大的羞辱。
So it was at this time that the Lord Balaram's army, the Yadu dynasty, they defeated all the army of Rukmini.
在这个时候呢，这个亚杜王朝的这个士兵在巴拉拉玛的这个指挥之下呢，打败了 Rukmini 的士兵。
And so when they came back to see Krishna, they were shocked to see that what Krishna had done to Rukmini. He cut off his beard and his hair.
所以当他们来到这个 Krishna 的这边的时候呢，他们为 Krishna 所做的一切感到非常的震惊。他们看到 Krishna 把这个 Rukmini 的头发和胡须都剃了下来。
So Lord Balaram was very compassionate to Rukmini, who was now his sister-in-law, and he felt very sorry for her.
所以说呢，这个 Balarama 他就非常同情这个 Rukmini， 因为 Rukmini 现在已经成为了他的妹夫。
And so Lord Balaram wanted to please Rukmini, so he untied Rukmini, because Krishna had tied him up, he'd taken him prisoner. But Balaram came there, he wanted to please Rukmini, so he untied him.
这个主 Balarama 为了取悦 Rukmini 呢，他就亲自给 Rukmini 给松了绑，因为呢 Rukmini 被 Krishna 绑了起来。Balarama 呢就为了取悦这个 Rukmini 就把他的哥哥给松绑了。
And to please Rukmini, he also, Lord Balaram also chastised Krishna and told Krishna, you shouldn't do this. This is, he's your relative.
这个 Balarama 呢，他就以 Krishna 哥哥的身份就训斥了 Krishna。他说到 Krishna, 你不应该这么做，你不应该对你的亲戚有这样的行为。
What you're doing, what you've done, this is not our family tradition.
你所做的这个事情并不符合我们的家庭传统。
You cut someone's hair and you shaved his mustache and beard. It's like killing him. It's like you killed him.
你这个剃掉了他的头发和胡须，这就跟你杀了他没有区别。
So even what Rukmini did, he's your brother-in-law. He's your relative.
这个无论他 Rukmini 他做了什么，他现在呢都是我们的姻亲，都是我们的亲戚。
So you shouldn't put him into such a condition.
你不应该使他这么难堪。
And then Lord Balaram he said to Rukmini, don't be sorry because your brother has been treated like this. He's been made.To look so funny, that don't take it. Don't worry about it.
然后呢，Balarama 又对 Rukmini 说道，不要因为你哥哥被弄成这个很滑稽的样子而感到难过。
Everybody suffers and enjoys the results of their past activities.
每个人都要承受自己过去行为的结果，无论是受苦还是享乐。
So Lord Balaram wanted Rukmini not to feel too bad about the situation.
所以呢 ，Balarama 试图安慰 Rukmini， 让他不要因为这样的情况而感到难过。
And she shouldn't have too much affection for her brother.
她不应该对她的哥哥有如此的这种依附之情。
And then Lord Balaram turned to Krishna and said.That Krishna, a relative, even if he commits a mistake and deserves to be killed, he should not be killed. You should excuse him.
然后 Balarama 呢又转向 Krishna， 对 Krishna 说道，亲爱的 Krishna， 作为我们的亲戚，即使他犯了弥天大罪，你应该被杀死，但是呢，我们也不应该杀死他。还是应该要原谅他。
If a relative, if he knows he did something wrong, and then he'll feel very bad about it, and that guilt is like death.
如果我们的这个亲戚呢意识到自己的错误，他会觉得非常的羞愧，而这样的羞愧呢，使他感到生不如死。
So then Balaram turned towards Rukmini.And told her about the duty of the Kshatriyas in human society.
然后呢 ，Balarama 就接下来又转向 Rukmini， 训示他有关人类社会当中查崔亚的负定职责。
And he told her that sometimes in fighting, sometimes the brother will become an enemy.
他就说到呢，有的时候在战场上。兄弟俩会成为敌人。
And that time, then the Kshatriya, he won't hesitate to kill even his own brother.
作为查崔亚，他们甚至会毫不犹豫杀死自己的兄弟。
So Lord Balaram wanted to tell Rukmini that Rukmi and Krishna were right in not showing mercy to each other.
以这样的方式呢 ，Balarama 是在教导 Rukmini。实际上 ，Rukmi 和 Krishna 他们的这种作战时毫不留情的行为是正确的。
Even though they have family connections, that they don't need to show mercy to each other when they're fighting.
即便他们之间有家族关系，有这种亲戚关系，但是他们在作战的时候呢，并不会向对方仁慈。
So Balaram told Rukmini that Kshatriyas are. They're typical materialistic people.
所以呢 ，Balarama 就告诉 Rukmini， 查崔亚实际上是典型的物质主义者。
They become proud whenever they get some material position or wealth.
当查崔亚得到一些物质的富裕和地位的时候呢，他们会变得非常的骄傲自大。
And so when there's a fight between different Kshatriyas, when they fight over the land, or they fight over money, or women, then that is their nature.
所以说呢，就当查崔亚们开始作战的时候呢，无论是他们为了这个王国，为了土地，还是为了钱财和女人而作战。这对他们来说是很自然的事情。
They will fight and they will try to put the other person into a terrible condition.
他们都会呢，极力的把对方置于死地。
So Balaram, Lord Balaram told Rukmini that her feeling for her brother was only creating the feeling which she had for her brother.Was just this is just this is just due to their material affection for each other.
所以呢，这个主 Balarama 就告诉 Rukmini， 就对他说呢，你对你哥哥的这种感情，实际上是创造出的是一种物质的情感。
Actually, her brother Rukmi, he had created bad feelings with many people.
实际上这个,
sorry, Guru, I didn't get the meaning. Rukmi, the brother, he was responsible for making many enemies because of the way in which he dealt with people.
他就说到呢，这个 Rukmi 实际上他因为他自己的这个与别人相处的方式呢，使得他招致了很多的敌人。
So Rukmini's affection for her brother was not really necessary.
因此呢, Rukmini 对她哥哥的这种感情, 并不是, 就是说不是必要的,
her brother's character was not good. He was of a very bad character.
她哥哥的这种品性呢, 非常的不好, 她的品德很恶劣。
And the way he had treated his friends and the way he treated Rukmini also was not really good.
这个他的哥哥呢,对待他朋友的方式,以及对待他妹妹Rukmini的方式呢,都并不好。
So he was actually not fit to be her brother.
所以他不配当Rukmini的哥哥。
But still Rukmini was feeling lenient towards him.
但即便如此呢, Rukmini 仍然对他的哥哥充满了感情。
Okay, we will stop here today.
今天我们就讲到这里。
Are there any questions?
请问大家有没有什么问题? 维达瓦提, Devadasi。
Yeah.
Hare Krishna, 顶拜 Guru Day, 请问 Rukmini 的哥哥, 他不知道自己的力量和 Krishna 很悬殊吗? 知道的话, 为什么还和 Krishna 对抗? 感恩。 I wanted to ask that the Rukmini's brother, doesn't he know his power is less than Krishna? If he knows why, he fight with Krishna. Thank you.
He doesn't know. He doesn't know Krishna's God. He thinks Krishna's an ordinary person. And he thinks he can defeat him. And that's why he had so many other kings also there. So he was very confident that he could defeat Krishna.
这个Rukmini的哥哥 Rukmi 他并不知道 Krishna 是神, 他只是把 Krishna 当成是一个普通人，所以他就认为呢，他可以打败 Krishna， 因为呢，当时呢还有很多其他的王子在鼓励他，所以呢他就非常自信满满的认为他可以打败 Krishna。
Yeah, he's thinking Krishna is an ordinary person.
他认为 Krishna 是一个普通人。
You have to understand, Sishupal was also a very powerful person. He was very rich. He had a lot of power. He was a great king. He was also strong.
你要知道，这个Sishupala他也是一个非常有力量的人物。他拥有大量的财富。他身体非常的强壮。他也是一个国王。他也非常的有力量的。He
was very opulent. So actually, you know, he could have married Rukmini. He was a king. He had a great kingdom, and she was a princess. She was a king's daughter, so she was being married into a wealthy family.
这个施术帕伦他也是一个拥有很多富裕的人。他是一个王子，他要成为这个国王的。 所以他和这个一个国王的女儿Rukmini结婚，实际上也是门当户对的。You
see, in the Vedic culture, they don't allow the young women to pick their own. Usually they won't allow for the young woman to pick the man they want to marry. The marriages will be arranged by the family.
在这个韦达传统当中呢，他们是不允许年轻的女子去选择自己的丈夫的。嗯，通常是这个丈夫是由这个家族来安排的。
So Rukmini's father, he thought Krishna would be a good husband for his daughter, but Rukmi, he didn't want Krishna to be the husband for his sister.
这个 Rukmini 的父亲呢，他认为 Krishna 是他女儿的这个丈夫的好人选，但是呢，他的哥哥 Rukmi 却觉得这个 Krishna 不好。
So out of respect for the older brother, for his oldest son, he let the father let the oldest son decide who his sister should marry.
所以呢，就是出于对这个长子的这个尊敬，所以这个父亲呢，就让他的长子来决定这个 Rukmini, 嫁给谁。
And Rukmini had never met Krishna, but she'd heard about him.And she wanted to marry him. She'd heard about him from Narada Muni.
这个那Rukmini 呢，她从来没有见过 Krishna， 但是呢，她听说过 Krishna， 所以说她非常想嫁给 Krishna。她之前呢是从 Narada Muni 那里听说有关 Krishna 的讯息的。
And we have to understand that Rukmini is not an ordinary woman.That she's actually the goddess of fortune, and she came from the spiritual world just to take part in Krishna's pastimes.
我们要知道 Rukmini 她并不是一个普通的女人，实际上她是幸运女神本人，她是从灵性世界来的，来到这里，参与主 Krishna 的逍遥时光。
So.Shishupal, actually, he's not really the husband of Rukmini. It's Krishna who is always the husband of Rukmini. They're eternally husband and wife.
所以呢，西树胖呢，并不是 Rukmini 真正的丈夫。Rukmini 真正的丈夫是Krishna. 他们是永恒的伴侣，永恒的丈夫和妻子。
So, Rukmi.He didn't know this, he didn't understand this, of course. It's all Leela, these pastimes are all arranged, you could say, for the pleasure of Lord Krishna.
Rukmini 呢对所有的这一切都并不知道。当然了，这些都是 Leela, 都是逍遥时光。所有的这一些呢都是被安排好的，用来取悦 Krishna, 来享受这个逍遥时光的。
By performing all of these pastimes, then we are able to hear more about Lord Krishna, about his activities, about how much he enjoys these dealings with his different devotees.
通过聆听这些逍遥时光呢，我们有更多的机会能够聆听到 Krishna 所上演的活动，聆听到他是如何与他的奉献者们一起享受逍遥时光的。
Okay. Yuvati Sachi has a question.
Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj, please accept my humble obeisances, all Guru Srila Prabhupada. Lord Balaram wasn't satisfied with what Krishna did with Rukmi when Krishna cut his hair. And what was Krishna supposed to do with Rukmi? What could be properly and what could be right?
what would be the proper punishment, you mean?
yes, Guru Maharaj.
Can I translate?
Yeah.
这个 Mataji 他就问到呢，这个刚才主 Balarama 就对 Krishna 说到，你这样去惩罚这个 Rukmi 的方式是不对的，所以 Mataji 就问。这个 Krishna 就是如何去惩罚 Rukmi 才是正确的，才是恰当的。
Well, actually, Krishna did that was the proper punishment in one way. He was going to kill him, but he didn't kill him. He just cut off his hair. His hair will grow again, and his hair did grow again. And you'll see, actually, there's another pastime later on where they meet together. And at that time, Balaram kills Rukmini. It's Lord Balaram who kills
him. 实际上呢，这个 Krishna 这个在这里惩罚 Rukmini 的方式呢，并非不恰当。嗯，在某种意义上来说是这样的，因为呢，这个 Krishna 原本要把这个 Rukmini 给杀死，但是呢，他没有把他杀死，只是把他的头发和胡须给削了下来，而头发和胡须呢，嗯，最终还是会长出来的。 但是我们看到在后面的有一个小时光里头，嗯，Balarama杀死了Rukmini。Yeah,
later on there was another pastime. We'll hear how Rukmini actually is killed by Balaram.
嗯，在后面呢有一个小时光，我们会聆听到Rukmini是如何被主 Balarama 杀死的。You
could say Krishna punished him. Krishna punished Rukmini in this way, just to humiliate him, to make him more angry and more embittered towards Krishna. Make him more angry and more enemy of Krishna.
Okay. 这个 Krishna 呢对待 Rukmini 的这种方式呢，实际上，嗯，只不过是为了羞辱他。 使得他对 Krishna 产生更大的愤怒。
Yes, Guru Maharaj, it's clear now. Thank you very much.
Okay. Yes. Are there any other questions?
Yes, Subhuti Royal Das.
Okay.
Hare Krishna, 顶拜 Guru Deva, 感恩翻译，请问 Rukmini。 Rukmini除了是Rukmini的哥哥之外，算不算是 Rukmini的奉献者？因为听到他非常爱 Rukmini. About the Rukmini, is he the brother of Rukmini? Is he a devotee of Rukmini? Because I heard that he loves Rukmini very much.
Yes, it's true that he has feeling for Rukmini as his sister, but he's opposed to her marrying Krishna.
嗯，是这样的，这个 Rukmini 呢，他作为 Rukmini 的哥哥，他是非常喜爱他的妹妹的，但是呢，他却反对 Rukmini 与 Krishna 结婚。
Just like somebody, you know, you may have parents who love you very much, but they don't want you to be a devotee, you know.
就好比说是你的父母是非常爱你的，但是呢，他们却反对你成为奉献者。
You're a devotee, but your family don't want you to be a devotee.
你是一名奉献者，但是呢，你的家人不想让你成为奉献者。
They want to take you away from Krishna.
他们想要把你从 Krishna 身边带走。
So that's not devotional service.
那并不是奉献服务。
And you could say he's not really a devotee of Rukmini. He just has some bodily affection for her.
所以说呢，你可以说这个 Rukmini 并不是 Rukmini 的一个真正的奉献者。 他们的关系呢，只不过是一种躯体化的这种关系，就躯体化的感情。We just heard
about Rukmini, that Rukmini was feeling affection for Rukmini, but Prabhupada was saying that Rukmini was a bad person. There's no reason to feel affection for him.
这个我们听到呢，这个 Rukmini 对他的哥哥 Rukmini 充满了感情，但是呢，我们在 Prabhupada的要旨当中说到，看到呢，这个 Rukmini 并不应该对他的哥哥有这种深厚的感情，因为 Rukmini 他是一个道德品行不端的人。嗯，
and here you see, Rukmini is trying to take Rukmini away from Krishna. That's like, just like in Ramayana, you have Ravan tries to take Sita away from Ram.
就好比是在罗马衍那的逍遥时光当中，Ravana 试图把 Sipa 从 Rama 的身边抱走。
You cannot say Ravana is a great devotee of Sita.
你不能说 Ravana 是 Sita 的伟大奉献者。
He just wanted to have a relationship with Sita, but Sita is the property of Lord Ram.
嗯 ，Ravana 呢，他只是想要去享受这个 Sita， 但是呢 ，Sita 实际上是 Rama 的财产。
So I was telling you, Rukmini is the property of Lord Krishna eternally. You cannot take it away from Lord Krishna.
所以说呢，我们可以说 Rukmini 是 Krishna 永恒的财产。你不可能把 Rukmini 从 Krishna 的身边带走。
So you have to be very careful.
所以你得非常小心。
Who is a devotee of who?
谁是谁的奉献者？
Devotional service must be favorable to Krishna.
奉献服务，一定是，就是，奉献服务一定是取悦 Krishna 的。
It must be favorable to Krishna, just like.Kamsa is always thinking of Krishna, but he's thinking how to kill Krishna.
就是这个奉献服务呢，一定是善于这个善待 Krishna 的。就好比这个 Kamsa， 他虽然总是想着 Krishna， 但是他想的却是怎么杀死 Krishna。
Okay, any other questions here?
No question. So Woody Royal Prabhu saying that, thank you. Thanks to Guru.
Okay. All right. So.
Another question.
Oh, yeah.
Vaishnavi Vani.
Yes.
Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj, is too much affection within family members not good?这个马塔吉问到，就是家庭成员之间的这种太多的这种情感是不是不好的
？Yes, you have to be a little cautious about these things. The family affection can become very bewildering.
所以呢，对这个家庭成员之间的这种感情来说呢，我们应该非常的谨慎，因为有的时候这种。家庭关系的这种情感呢，会让人迷惑。
At the same time, we have affection, we have some relationship there, you have some responsibility. You cannot be neglectful.
这与此同时呢，这个家人之间的这种情感总是会存在一些的，总是有这种家庭的责任在那里。你不能忽视你的家人。
But we have to be careful. We shouldn't.Allow it to obstruct our devotional service.
但是呢，同时我们要非常的小心，我们不能让这种情感妨碍了我们去履行奉献服务。
If it becomes an obstacle to our devotional service, then eventually you have to give up the family relationship.
如果呢，这种情感已经妨碍了你从事奉献服务，成为了你奉献服务道路上的障碍。那么最终来说，你要放弃这种家庭关系。
Just like Srila Prabhupada.
就好像 Srila Prabhupada.
He had a family, and he was trying to preach. He was staying at home and he was trying to preach, but the family were not supporting. The family were opposing.
就好比是薛拉帕乌帕，他也有家人。当他还是居士的时候呢，他也在尝试着传教，但是呢，他的家人并没有支持他，反而在反对他。
And so he understood it was time for him to leave the home.
所以他就明白了，现在呢是他要离开家庭的时候了。
Of course, we have to be very careful about leaving home. That's not an easy thing to do.
当然了，这个对于离开家庭这件事呢，我们要非常的小心。这种事呢，并不容易的。
it's maybe easy, a lot easier for men to do, not really encourage women to do it.
这个离开家庭呢，对于男人来说，可能容易做到，但是呢，我们并不鼓励女人离开家庭。
Generally, women should be protected by their family.
通常来说呢，妇女应该受到家庭的保护。
But we should be careful about, we should always understand that the family, that they're not going to be able to protect us from birth and death.
但是呢，有一点我们要明白，我们的家庭，我们的家人并不能够保护我们免于生老病死。
We should always remember our family members are also spirit souls. They are also part and parcel of Krishna.
我们应该始终记住，我们的家人呢也是灵性的灵魂，他们也是Krishna的一部分。
We should think of every living entity as a family member.
我们应该把所有的生物体都当成是我们的家人。
We're all parts and parcels of Krishna.
我们所有人都是Krishna的一部分。
There was one Christian saint, and there was this one Saint Francis, and he would speak to the flowers and trees. He would address them as my brother tree, my dear sister flower.
有一个基督教的圣人呢，他总是把这个鲜花和树木呢称为是他的兄弟姐妹。 他会称呼那个树木为我的兄弟树木，称那个鲜花为我的姐妹鲜花。So
when Prabhupada heard about this, he said, "Oh, this is real God consciousness."
但是呢，帕布法听到他的这个名言的时候呢，他觉得他真的是具有神性的知觉。So,
In the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna said that he is the seed-giving father of all living entities.
在《薄伽梵歌》当中，Krishna说到，我是所有生物体播种的父亲。So
Krishna is the father of everyone, and the Vedas are the mother.
所以 Krishna呢是所有生物体的父亲，而伟达经是所有人的母亲。
We want to cultivate that kind of consciousness. The family members in the Bhagavad Gita, in the Srimad Bhagavatam, they're described like fallible soldiers. That, you know, although they stay with us, you may stay with them, and they try to help you, but they cannot save you from birth and death.
在圣典薄伽瓦堂当中呢，他们其中说到呢，这个家庭成员呢，也许会能够帮助到我们一点，但是呢，他们不能够帮助我们免于生老病死。We
come together in one family, and then we leave that family, we go to another, we take birth somewhere else, just like you get in a train. You sit with people on the train, and then you travel with them for a day or two, and then you never see them again. And so the same way, we come together in a family, and we live together as a family, but then we separate, we never see each other again.
圣殿薄伽瓦坛里面就把这个家庭成员呢，就把家人呢，比作是一个漂浮着的这种浮萍一样，就是在某一段时间呢，我们和某一些人成为家人，然后居住在一起。但是呢，过一段时间之后呢，也就分开了。这就好比是你在坐火车，就是有的人他陪你坐一段旅程，可能是一天或者两天，但是之后呢，就又分开了，就再也见不到彼此了。这个我们的家人就好比是这样的。So
be careful in the family affairs. Don't get too much affectionate. Don't be too deeply attached.
所以呢，对于这种家庭关系来说呢，我们要非常的小心。这种情感呢，就是
不要太这个太深的衣服，不要有这种太深的衣服。
We want to be attached to Krishna.
我们应该依附 Krishna.
We want to be attached to devotional service.
我们应该依附奉献服务。
If we just get attached to the family, we spend our whole time just dedicating our whole life just to take care of the family, to make money for the family.
我们在家的话，就把全部的时间都花在了这个照顾家人身上，这个去赚钱维系家人。
So, be careful.
所以我们要小心。
We keep relationships with the family, deal with them nicely, and encourage them, and at the same time, internally be attached to Krishna.
这个就是我们保持着这种家庭的关系，然后非常好的善待他们，鼓励他们。与此同时呢，我们在内心里培养对 Krishna 的依附。
Okay. Any other?
Jai Govinda, Devadasi, 顶拜 Guru 和翻译 Krishna 如此的羞辱 Rukmi 没有了尊严和死亡，没什么区别，会不会影响 Rukmini 对 Krishna 的情感？现实中若是发生这样的事情，妻子肯定觉得丈夫的做法是，对丈夫的做法是不满的。谢谢。Krishna humiliate the Rukmi, so without the self respect, there is no difference with the death. So is this affect the feelings of Rukmini towards Krishna? In our actual life, if this kind of thing happened, the wife must be unsatisfied to her husband. Thank you.
Yes, if the wife is in the bodily platform, but you have to understand Rukmini is actually not on the bodily platform. She's not an ordinary woman, a normal conditioned soul. She's an eternal liberated soul who's come from the spiritual world. So her affection is to Krishna, and not just to some bodily relationship.
你所说的这个在现实当中如果发生这样的情况的话呢，也许是的，这个妻子会对丈夫不满，但是呢这是因为妻子她是处在躯体化的层面上面，但是呢我们要知道 Rukmini 她并不是一个普通的妇女，她不是一个普通的受条件限制的灵魂，实际上呢她是一个来自于灵性世界的永恒解脱的灵魂。那么她对这个 Krishna 的这种情感呢是这种超然的灵性的情感。她 Rukmini 对 Krishna 的这种情感呢并不是处在躯体化的层面。
We have to understandRukmini is not an ordinary woman. She is not a conditioned soul.
你要知道 Rukmini 并不是一个普通的妇女，她不是一个普通的受条件限制的灵魂。
So while she feels some affection for her brother, just like we heard how she prayed to Krishna not to kill him, at the same time, her affection is more to Krishna than to her brother.
当然呢，这个 Rukmini 呢，对他的哥哥有一定的情感，因此呢，他恳求这个 Krishna 不要杀死他的哥哥。但是呢，与跟他的哥哥的之间的这种情感相比较来说呢，他与 Krishna 之间的这种情感更加的深厚。
So Rukmini is.You know, this is a drama. She's come to this material world and she's playing the part. Although she's an eternal devotee of Lord Krishna, she's born in this family where she has this really demon brother.
Mini， 他虽然是永恒解脱的灵魂，但是呢，他来参与这个逍遥时光，他出生在这一个家族当中。
So it's all Lila, Krishna's pastimes.
所以呢，这一切都是 Lila， 都是 Krishna 的逍遥时光。
And Krishna enjoys seeing his devotees, how they go through these different situations and how they express their love for him.
所以呢，Krishna 呢就非常享受这样的逍遥时光。他就看这些奉献者们呢是如何这个就是超越这些不同的情况，这不同的处境的，来经历这些不同的处境，来表达，他们对他的爱。
This is Krishna's pleasure, his loving dealings with his devotees.
这是 Krishna 的快乐，就是他 Krishna 和奉献者们之间这种不同的交流。
Just like the gopis, they gave up their chastity just for Krishna.
就如同这个 gopi 们，他们为了 Krishna 甚至放弃了他们的贞洁。
So the same way Rukmini, she could see her brother put through this humiliation, but she understands ultimately her love is for Krishna.
所以如果 Mini 呢，他就见证了他的哥哥就是承受这种被羞辱的，这一境况，让他能够明白，实际上他，最爱的人是 Krishna.
Then she can also understand
同时呢，他也知道他的哥哥实际上是自作自受，因为他的哥哥是一个，这个恶棍，他做了那么多的坏事情。
It was her brother didn't ask her who she wanted to marry. He just told her, "You get married to him."
Sorry.
Her brother didn't tell Rukmi didn't tell Rukmini.He didn't ask her, who do you want to marry? He didn't care about who she wanted to marry. He told her, you should marry Sishupal.
因为呢，这个他的哥哥 Rukmi， 他甚至没有询问过他妹妹 Rukmini 本人的，意见。他想要去嫁给谁？他的哥哥呢，就并没有在乎这个妹妹的，这是他自己的这种想法。他就直接就命令他的妹妹，你要嫁给西树帕了。
If he really cared about his sister, he should have consulted her. He could have asked her, who would you like to marry? And if she told him Krishna, he should have agreed. But he didn't want her to marry Krishna. He's forcing her to marry 西树帕。
所以呢，如果他真的关心他的妹妹的话，他应该问他妹妹的意见，应该征求他的他本人的意见，他想要去嫁给谁。实际上，如果他问的话，如果 Mini 会告诉他想嫁给 Krishna， 他本来应该同意，他的妹妹去嫁给 Krishna 的，但是呢，如果 Mini 却强迫他的妹妹去嫁给西苏帕了。
So he hadn't been very nice to his sister. So why should his sister worry too much about him?
所以呢，他对他的妹妹呢，实际上并不好。那么，这个妹妹呢，为什么要那么担心他的哥哥呢？
Okay, are there more questions?
可以吗？More question. Jai Govinda says, okay, thanks to Guru.
Thanks to Jai Govinda.Hare Krishna.
谢谢加格文达。Shri David Gorangi, David Ashi, Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj. Sometimes we see when a devotee is very ill or hospitalized, is the family members, although they are long devotees, who are there to assist the devotee, not the devotees. This happens in cases Well, there is a poorly managed devotee care system in the management or congregation or none at all in place. Even daily prasada is not provided for the devotee or no arrangements are made. I have experienced lack of such devotee care some years ago, and I have tried to provide such care in my own capacity. How do we make ISKCON devotees more caring and empathetic and realistic towards devotees who are ill and unable to cook or offer their own food in their period of illness? 这个 Manaji 就说到，Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj， 有时候呢，我们看到有一名奉献者，他身中病或者是住院了，然后呢是他的家人，虽然他的家人呢并不是奉献者，是他的家人在照顾这位生病的或者是住院的奉献者，就是在我看我就是我知道有很多这样的情况发生，就是在一个就是奉献者关爱体系并不完善的地方，会有这样的事情，甚至是每天的这个菩萨等都不能够提供给到这个奉献者啊，或者是甚至是没有安排。
Yes, this is a problem. You're right, Sri Devi Mataji, this is true. We have to try to upgrade our devotee care.
这个Sri Devi Mataji 您说的是对的，这种事情是有的，所以说呢我们要改善我们的奉献者关爱体系。
We have to feel more caring and be concerned to help our devotees. It's not only we can't just expect the family members to do it, but
所以呢我们要更加的关心，更加的去照顾奉献者，而不要总是去指望家庭成员。
Of course, sometimes we get problems from the family that the family don't want us to come to help their people.
当然呢，有的时候呢，这个对于家庭成员呢，也会有一些困难。有的时候，他们的家人呢，就是奉献者的家人，并不允许我们来去照顾那位奉献者。
We have experience of these things that sometimes the family members say, "Don't interfere. We're taking care. We will do it our way."
这个我们也经历过这样的事情，就是这个奉献者的家庭成员不允许我们去干涉他们的家事，不允许我们去照顾那名奉献者。
We have cases sometimes the elderly devotees are put into old people's homes, and there's nothing to eat. There's no vegetarian food, no opportunity.
就是我们之前也有过这样的例子，有一些年老的奉献者呢，就被他们的家人送到了养老院，但是在养老院呢，并没有素食，就没有prasada可以吃。
But the family members insist that that's where the people have to go. They want to put the person into the old people's home. They don't want them in the home, in their own home. They put them in the government, old people's home.
但是呢，这都是这些他的这些家人，做的事情，就是他的这些家人呢，不想让这个年老的奉献者待在家里，所以呢，他们就把他送到了养老院，送到了这个政府运营的这些养老院里面。
So we try to make people more aware of these things. We try to organize these things. It's not easy.
所以我们就试着让人们就更多的去关注到这样的事情，我们尝试着做更好的安排。
And we hope as our movement, as things go on, we hope in the future we can become more caring and more conscious and try to help our devotees, try to help our devotees at least.
所以说呢，我们就希望我们的运动能够，随着我们运动的发展呢，我们能够更多的去关爱奉献者，去照顾奉献者，就是在这样的情况下去帮助他们。
It's certainly our responsibility.
当然了，这是我们每一个人的责任。
I know in the Christian church, they have like that. They have the man from the church will go around the people, he'll go around the elderly people and they'll go to see them. And if somebody's in the hospital, they'll go to the hospital and speak to them.
I can't understand.
If somebody's in the Christian church, they have the system. That the head of the church, the priest, he will be the one, he will go to meet the different members of the congregation.
Okay. 就是在那个基督教的这个教堂里面呢，他们就有这种关爱体系，他们就是这个基督教堂的这个牧师，他会亲自就是去看望那些生病的那些基督教的成员，就是那个祭司会亲自去看望他们。
And if somebody's in the hospital, they go to hospital and to see them and wish them well.
如果这个有这个成员的话，生病住院的话，这个牧师呢，他就会去到医院去看望这个病人，去看望他们。
And there are some hospitals even in America. There's one hospital in New York.Where there's a devotee, he works, and his job is to take care of people and to go and see them and to help them and care for them, you know, especially people who are leaving the body soon. He will give them, maybe pray with them, offer prayers, and give comforting words to them.
所以呢，在这个美国纽约的一家医院里面呢，就有一名奉献者，就是在这家医院里工作。那他的这个工作专门就是去看望那些生重病的人，就是帮助那些即将离开躯体的人。就是如果有病人即将离开躯体的话呢，他就去给他祈祷，然后给他说一些安慰的话。
It's a science. People have to be trained. They have to be trained how to do these kind of things. And in some parts of the world, our devotees are learning how to do this.
实际上呢，这个关爱是一门学问。奉献者们呢，应该受到训练来去做这个事情。在世界上其他的一些地方呢，已经有奉献者开始在学习这门技术。
I know in Singapore we have two devotees there, or maybe more, but at least two devotees, one devotee couple, and they go to see the cancer patients. They're all cancer patients, but they meet with them regularly and they arrange activities for them.
我知道呢，在新加坡有两名奉献者，当然呢，可能不止两名，但是至少呢有两名，他们是一对夫妇，就是他们就专门去看望那些癌症病人，就是为那些癌症病人呢去举办一些活动，就举办一些特别的活动。
Yeah, they'll play some games together with them and read a little bit and give some nice prasadam to them.
他们的服务呢，就是为那些癌症病人呢去安排一些游戏，和他们一起读书，并且呢，提供菩萨的。
And the people who come, you know, they don't present really a Krishna consciousness directly, but the people appreciate very much the program.
虽然呢，他们就是这对夫妇，并没有直接的去给到他们 Krishna 知觉，就是并没有直接的去传播 Krishna 知觉，但是呢，他们举办的这些活动呢，都受到了很好的欢迎。
Okay, thank you very much. Any other questions there?
No question anymore.
Okay, so we thank Tosi Gopinath Mariji very much for her translation. Wamafe Changanshiya Tosi Gopinath Mataji Giwama Jintai Dafani Wamaganshiya Shoya the functions of LinkedIn. We thank all the devotees. Hare Krishna, Srila Prabhupada
Ki. Thank you, Guru Maharaj.
Thank you, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. 先生们，我们今天的讲课到此结束。祝大家晚安，Hare Krishna. Thank you, Guru Maharaj.
Hare Krishna.